there was a child that died in the A&E, and we're ringing this little child across the back yard of the hospital. We came as far as the mortuary, now this is the old mortuary, and we realised that the compactor was being used, and there was two lads there getting rid of a whole of rubbish. We just turned around. I remember having the child in my arms. We turned around and we went back into the hospital, back upstairs into a room, and we said, this is much more dignified to have a room.
If we can create one exemplar, such as in the case of Mercy Hospital Mortuary in Cork, and show that to other hospitals so that they can see what's actually achievable within a realistic budget and time frame, and a bit of inspiration and a bit of good design, then I think that that is really doing its job well.
Approximately 300 patients die in the hospital, which really equates to approximately 2,000 families being affected by a loss here.
I think the one word I used to describe the mortuary before now was embarrassment. It was cold, it was dark inside in it, it was no soft lighting.
The aim of this whole thing was that the family could stay with the body until the undertakers came to collect them, or for as long as they wished.
The refurbished mortuary is a peaceful space where families can go catch their breath, where we can have removals from it if necessary. It's a multicultural, all-embracing mortuary.
We were lucky with our architects in-house at the time, so we asked them to come up with the concept of what could be possible and what might be done. We did that in conjunction with the design and dignity guidelines. It had to be functional, it had to be appropriate, and it had to be soft. We set up a user group in-house as well, where all the key stakeholders were consulted. We had a couple of brainstorming sessions with the architects, seeing what we wanted, seeing what was the best result, and we came up with the lovely plan that we have at the minute.
We had to consider a number of practical things. For example, there is a canopy sheltered area outside the mortuary itself with the seating area for relatives who may want to go and sit outside. We can now have removals from the mortuary. We also have a wheelchair accessible bathroom.
While we do have a hygienic carpet down, it's still a carpet. We're not allowed to put that in any of our clinical areas at the minute. It washes up to 100 degrees, so there is a practicality about it. This whole wall here, where we actually have a storage space in behind it, it's ash, and it's kind of a concealed door in it, where behind it, if necessary, we have some storage, and if necessary, to hold the mortuary trolley.
To be sit down on the garden bench and just be able to be on your own. Sometimes people just need to be on their own.
I like this room because it belongs to all faiths, and it also belongs to those who have none.
It's a nicer space to work in compared with what was there.
For those who enter their journey in the Mercy Hospital, it's important to us that it's compassionate, peaceful, and is with dignity. So the mortuary is exceptional in terms of adding to that.
Having the expertise of the design and dignity architects is hugely important. Having a very good project team in the hospital, like we had, is hugely important. Having buy-in from everybody in the hospital is critical. Everybody has to realise the importance of the mortuary. We certainly would be very willing to open up our mortuary to anybody who would like to visit it and see what we have here, because we're very proud of what we have here now in the Mercy University Hospital.